Hey, welcome back to the Chat Builds. My name is Jarrell. Today I'm going to do the electrolysis of this tank. I've seen BJ doing this and other people. The tank needs to come clean, so the paint needs to come off, but I still got a lot of rust inside here. I'll show that in a minute. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use this piece of steel as an anode, use the battery, so I use a positive on this, negative on that, and then try and get the rust out that way. So I'm just going to prepare this and then we'll have a look inside the tank. So this is the sacrificial anode I'm going to use inside the tank, making sure that this doesn't touch the inside or the outside of the tank. The positive will go on this end, and the negative will go on a clean piece on the tank. Now the fluid inside the acid is this pH plus, so it's acid up. This is what you use in pools, and I've been told I need a cup full of this for like 10 liters of water. So I'm going to use some warm water, fill the tank up with stuff that's diluted in that. Stick the anode in, add two batteries with a charger on it, and then wait and see. So this is warm water. Let's see if I can do that this way. It's gonna be clumsy. Can show you the inside of the tank. That's pretty nasty looking. So hopefully we can get it out. It's all filled up. Tank is now full with water with the acid stuff. All we have to do is get some batteries and hook it up, and then it's a waiting game. Okay, so this is my setup. The two batteries in series, so they are one, giving a bit more power. I have the anode, stick that in there. Negative to the tank, to the negative, put it here. It's got a better grip on this. Okay, there it is. Okay. I'm going to put the charger on this one. Well, should be it. So negative to negative of the battery, positive to the positive of the battery. I've got these two linked up in series, and these are recharging the battery. Anode is in, the acid is in, and yeah, we'll just wait and see what happens. You should hear it fizzing. Yeah, I can hear it. And I've got these holes here because there's fumes coming out of this from the bubbles. It has to come out. Okay. So it's working. Just zoom in. You can see it bubbling. There's fumes as well that need to come out. So I have to do it again. I had it outside, but it was really cold. It was like -4, so that didn't help. So there's new water in here, warm water with more of the pH plus stuff inside. Tank is filled up completely, and I've actually got these in series. So this is now actually producing 24 volts to this anode. So I'll just prove I've got 24 volts here. So the multimeter is at 200, the red one stuck in there. I'll just push it on the ground here. There you see it, 24.6 volts. So that's really cool. And it's really bubbling. I can still see it going. Yeah. Don't know if you can on the video, but it was a bit of a trial and error, but yeah, it's working. Looks like the charger is charging as well, so I just have to keep an eye on that. See if that one doesn't get drained, but yeah, I had some problems with the wires because they were running really hot. So probably the anode was still attaching of a sticking to the tank or something, or a bad ground. But after some trial and error, I've got it now. So let's give this a couple of hours and have a look. Now that's bubbling a lot better. Look at that. So I did a lot thicker anode. First I had this, which I thought would be fine, but as you can see, that's all it did. And it gave little bubbles, but this is a lot better. So we're a couple of hours further. And it doesn't seem to work. This was the first one I used. And this is all that happened after a few hours. So, and the second one I did was thicker. It got a bit crunchier, but that's all it did. And then it stopped fizzing. So now I've used a long wire like this, which goes further into the tank. And yeah, it is bubbling, but not a lot. So I don't know, for some reason it is not working. So wait and see how this does. Have a look at it tonight. I've got it back in parallel now, because that one was really starting to get low. So it's parallel now, so we're doing 12 volts here. See that, how that works, but so far I'm not very enthusiastic about this. I'm probably doing something wrong, don't know what. But I will be buying some vinegar that is a lot easier and works a lot quicker as well.
So you can see it fizzing there. You see all these pictures with foam coming out of the thing? I haven't had anything like that, so I don't know.
So my little experiment here with the electrolysis, well, it completely not did anything. All I ended up with was a bolt looking like this after a full day. And the other one, it's a cap I made, same result. So that's all it did. Then I did another one, which was this. So that's a different kind of metal. I think this is stainless. It completely cooked the metal. So everything got a hammering except the tank. So it looks weird inside now. I don't know. But I think I'm gonna grab back to the method I'm used to with this, which is with vinegar and some water. Just pour in vinegar like this. This is like cleaning vinegar. I don't know how you call that in English. I'm gonna throw in that. So that's about three of these 5 liter packs, and then fill it up with water. Let it stand for about 24 hours, and maybe at the end throw in some screws and stuff, old screws or other strong things that are reasonably big that I can get out, and just shake it, and that usually does a trick really good. The only thing is that as soon as it goes out, you have to clear it out, and then I'm going to use WD-40, I think, to give the inside a coating so it won't rust again. And then I can tackle the front of the outside. But yeah, I'm really bummed out that it didn't work. I've tried, like you see with batteries, so with just one battery, with two batteries in parallel, and with two batteries in series. So I've actually had 24 volts going through this tank as well. It started off like bubbly. I've seen that as well, especially with the bigger piece of metal. Looked really good, but then it just kind of dies out. I've raised the acidity of the water as well with sodium carbonate, so that's like baking soda. There was already acid stuff in there, that pH plus stuff. I even added 200 grams of that salt. I thought that was a trick, but didn't do anything. So I'm gonna get rid of the stuff that's in here, and then I'm gonna put in the vinegar. I've seen me doing those tanks before with vinegar, so I'm gonna skip to the part where the vinegar is in for about 24 hours. I'll give it a good shake, and then let's see how that came out. So this came out of the tank, as you can see. Grab. This is what the tank looks like now. It's so cold right now. I'm just gonna put the torch on. As you can see, it's kind of nickel plated now. I think like a reaction to something. Maybe that last wire actually put down some sort of, I don't know, some sort of layer. There's still some vinegar in there. I'm just gonna do it again. Yeah, it's just too cold. So I still have some of this left from the former tanks. I kept this, so I drained the other tank and then I drained this off. So I'm just gonna try and see if this can do those last pieces over there. It's pretty strong stuff, this. So I'm gonna put the fuel cock back on and have another go. The tank is dry now. It is ready to be treated, but just wanna see if I can get the last bits out. tank is now in the tank cure. I've got it inside somewhere in the tank for this Honda. And this is the last the drain I took out. As you can see, it's well worth it. Yeah, tank is nearly clean. It's not 100%, I'd say, but 95% clean. So I'm hoping the tank cure will do it, but at least we got rid of this. The tank is done, I think, on the inside. Now, unfortunately, the electrolysis, it just didn't work. Maybe it just, it got it loose. I don't know, really. It did something, but you saw videos where all the foam came out like that. I've never had that. I changed around with different types of metal. I tried all different things. I was really sure it wasn't connecting inside the tank. I had good current. I had enough acid in the tank. I even added some later on. So why it didn't work, I still don't know. But maybe we'll have another go in like a paint can, something like that, just to try and work out what's going on. Because if it works, it's a pretty clean way of doing stuff. But in the end, I use the way I like to do it, which is just with 3/4 of vinegar, 1/4 of water, leave it stand for like 24 hours, throw in some screws, stuff like that, shake it really violently. And then maybe do it again. But that actually always works. I then rinse it out with water a couple of times. That will take out the last of the pieces of flakes of rust, usually, until the water that comes out is nice and clean. And then it's really quickly getting the tank dry. Now, I used to use compressed air, but I found that it starts to rust again really quickly. So what I've done now is I'm starting to use like cloths, just sticking it inside the tank, getting the water away, and that seems to work really good. Now this tank was really bad, even though I treated it before, yeah, and but now it looks really great. It's just like this piece right underneath the cap doesn't look so great, but the rest is actually completely clean. So the last thing I need to do now is spray it with WD-40, and that should stop rust starting again, because the next part is going to be the outside of the tank. And to remove that, there's a little dent here that has to be addressed, and then it can get a paint job, a new ring, O-ring underneath this, and a new petcock, and then this tank is ready to go on the bike. So that will be the first part of the fuel line and the ignition and running of the engine. So after this, it's going to be car work again. But first off, get the WD-40 in and try it stop rusting too much. Leave it like that, upside down, so the WD-40 can go to the bottom of to the top, actually, and then later on I'll flip it over back on this normal side, and then there should be WD-40 everywhere. So that was today's video. Yeah, another tank video. I know I've done a lot of those, but it is such an important part of the bike, and well, it's one of the big look parts of the bike as well. Hope you enjoyed it. And the tank is going to be for this bike over here, so not for the daily rider, but for this other Honda, which is behind me right here. I know the engine is good, the engine runs. I just need to get a nice good carb for it. But first off, a carb needs good clean fuel, and that comes from the tank. So, hey, yeah, thanks for watching. Please subscribe if you haven't already, and see you in the next one. And you can also find me on Instagram, which will be right over here. Yeah, please follow, and happy Christmas, I guess, nearly. Yeah, happy holidays. All right, bye-bye.